Hey everyone, today we will talk about how to design an ad serving platform. So let's get started. Let's talk about functional requirements. Advertisers should be able to add, update, view, or delete an ad campaign. Ad campaign would have target users, creative, budget per day, expiry, and redirect URL attached to it. System should be able to serve only suitable ads to target users based on gender, age, and location. System should be able to track ad impressions like ad views and ad clicks. System should be able to control the ad serving rate to avoid over-delivery. Campaign could be in either an active, expired, paused, or removed state. Advertisers should receive campaign report and invoice with total amount to pay. Now let's talk about the non-functional requirements. The system should be having very low latency. Also, the system should be highly available. Now let's talk about the design. Advertiser needs to sign up first. Okay. Now once he's logged in, an ad manager can manage ad campaigns using ad manager service. Okay. This service is responsible for ad view, update, and delete a campaign. Also, it allows ad manager to update the status of campaign like active, paused, expired, or removed, and its daily budget at any point of time. This service also enables ad manager to upload ad creatives in blog store, which get pulled further by CDN. All metadata info like advertiser ID, campaign status, media CDN URL, budget per day, age group, gender, locations, campaign expiry time, redirect URL if any, and the last update time mapping is stored in the ad manager DB. Cool. Now, user also needs to sign up first on the consumer platform. Once he is logged in, user device can cache the data like user ID, device ID, age group, gender, and location in the local device cache. There is a location mapping service also, which is responsible for translating last location of the device into geo hash along with the city, state, and country for ad serving purpose and store this data in the location DB. Cool. Now, every time an ad config gets updated, okay, ad manager service publishes an event in ad config update message queue, which gets consumed by ad delivery service. Now, ad delivery service maintains reverse mapping of all the eligible active campaigns for gender, age group, and location geo hashes in the cache. Ad delivery service also calls location service to resolve ad campaign's target locations into geo hash. Okay. Now, engagement tracking ID is something which also ad delivery service needs to send in order to make sure ad SDK client can send this back to engagement service once user views or clicks those particular ad campaigns. Okay. And engagement tracking ID can look like user ID underscore campaign ID underscore viewed underscore ad serve epoch time, or user ID underscore campaign ID underscore clicked underscore ad serve epoch time. Cool. Now, once engagement tracking service receives the views and click tracking IDs, okay, it pushes them to ad engagement message queue so that engagement aggregator could consume this and update the aggregate in the engagement tracking DB, like campaign ID, views aggregate, clicks aggregate, average cost per click so far, average cost per view so far. This is something which needs to be maintained in the engagement tracking DB. Now, what if user has seen or clicked an ad, but before actually sending the engagement metrics from the ad SDK client side, the user goes offline. Okay. To handle this situation, ad SDK will also maintain those engagement metrics, only those engagement metrics in local device cache, which has not been pushed so far to the engagement tracking service. Okay. Now, ad SDK pushes these engagement metrics once user comes online next time. Okay. So, ad SDK client is also maintaining engagement metrics, which has not been pushed to engagement tracking service, along with already seen ads in the local device cache. Cool. Now, daily reporting and invoice mailer service uses ad engagement DB and ad manager DB to generate campaign level report, having campaign ID, total views, total clicks, total ad spend, average cost per view, average cost per click, etc., and send the daily report to appropriate publisher along with the invoice for the total amount due so far, which need to be paid during next payment cycle. Cool. Now, we need to control ad serving rate for each campaign based on the daily budget and the budget exhausted so far. To handle this, every time ad delivery service delivers ad, okay, it sends ad serving data in the ad served message queue here, okay, which gets consumed by budget pacing service. Now, budget pacing service keeps daily budget and the budget exhausted so far in terms of percentage in the cache, so that ad delivery service can call budget pacing service in order to check ad serving rate also before serving the ads. Cool. Now, budget pacing service should also know the changes in the daily budget for a campaign, if any, right? To handle this, ad manager service needs to push the ad budget update in the ad budget update message queue, which gets consumed by budget pacing service. In case daily budget has been reduced already by less than what is what we have exhausted for the day, okay, in this condition we should not count this particular case as over delivery. Okay, in order to handle this, probably we can consider changes in the daily budget from next day or tonight 12 a.m. Okay, cool. So this is how we have designed the system so far. Okay, please share your feedback. Hope you like the video. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.